Ladies and gentlemen, we will hear the valedictory of our honoree, Police General Rodolfo Santos Azurin Jr.
Troop Commander, please give tikas painga.
Tikas!
Ho!
No, tikas. Ho!
To our guest of honor and speaker who will be introduced later, His Excellency President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr., President of the Republic of the Philippines, the Honorable Gloria Macapagal Arroyo Ma'am, former President of the Republic of the Philippines and now the Deputy Speaker of the House of Representatives, the Secretary of the Interior, the Secretary of the Department of the Interior and Local Government, Attorney Benjamin C. Abalos Jr., sir, other department secretaries, members of the Diplomatic Corps, members of the Senate, members of the House of Representatives, to my successor, the 29th Chief of the Philippine National Police, Major General Benjamin Kasuga Accorda Jr. and his family, heads and representatives of the other government agencies, commanders and chiefs of the military and other uniformed personnel, former chiefs of the Philippine National Police, also known as the Council of Elders, the PNP Command Group and the other brave and diligent men and women of the Philippine National Police, the members of the National Advisory Group for Police Transformation and Development, the Kasimbayanan and other stakeholders, my mistas and members of the PMA Makatao Class of 1989 and the members of the PNP Officers Ladies Club, to my wife, Mary Grace Azurin, and our children, Martin, Nina, and Aaron. Also, to my mother, Erlinda, and stepdad, Arthur Pengosro, and my siblings. To the members of the media, other distinguished guests who are with us today, either physically or through Facebook Live, isang mapagpala at napakagandang umaga ngayong aking araw ng karawan. As I end my 8-month journey as 28th Chief of the Philippine National Police, I want to share with you the Latin phrase, Fiat Justitia Ruat Silum. Let justice be done, though the heavens fall. Today, the PNP is again at a crossroads, whether to continue the status quo or pursue the move to purge the organization of Iskalawags. I receive both praises and criticisms for pursuing the fight against illegal drugs, which stem from the seizure of some 990 kilos of shabu in Manila last year. Hell broke loose while many tried to dip their fingers on the issue. The PNP is now under scrutiny, but I trust our Lord and our people that justice will be on our side once we have brought to justice those involved in the proliferation of drugs in our country. In a few days, more reports will come out, and I hope my successor will be able to continue what we started and pursue this cause. My journey for the past 38 years since my graduation from the Philippine Military Academy has not been easy. There were many challenges since my deployment in 1989 in 1st Special Action Company in Parang, Maguindanao. My stint in the now-defunct Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Task Force, Highway Patrol Group, the Office of the Comptrollership, Regional Director of the Ilocos Region, Provincial Director of Benguet, Police Provincial Office, and so on, molded me into what I am today. My experiences made me strong, yet discerning. I saw opportunities during times of challenges, and I hope in every situation. I can say, I always see the glass as half full. While many portrayed me as a meek individual, little did they know the real me, an action man, decisive, strong, and results-oriented. My career has been a colorful and exciting. Many of the highlights merit recognition, while the rest better be left archived in my heart and in my memory. When my career was in its lowest, there were people who were constantly with me. My family, especially my wife, Geiki, please stand up. And my three children, Martin, Aaron, and Nina. I also pay tribute to my parents, Erlinda, stepdad Arthur, and my siblings, whom I share our sacrifices while we were growing up. My mistas and selected number of trusted friends, please stand up. My mistas and a select number of trusted friends who never lost their trust and confidence in me also made me go on without hesitation to serve the PNP and the Filipino people. While I battled the odds to serve the PNP and the country, I have never lost hope that our Almighty God will help me carry on. I am also grateful for the trust given to me by our people, especially President Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos Jr. I believe my strong character and unwavering commitment to serve our country and the Filipino people can be rooted on how my uncle, Captain Ramon Azurin, exhibited undivided loyalty to the late Apo President Ferdinand Edralin Marcos Sr. This is why I have served the present administration with the same fervor and patriotism. I still recall my meeting with our dear President Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos Jr. and our dear First Lady Marie Louise Marcos on a separate occasion when they extended to me their best regards while I assumed the top police post. I can say I remain true to my promise to ensure peace and order and stability while President Marcos marks his first year in office. These promises I think I have fulfilled in the past 8 months of my stint with help of my counterparts in the Armed Forces of the Philippines and the Uniformed Services. Palakpakan po natin ang ating counterparts sa Armed Forces. And of course, Senator Amy Marcos, NICA Director General Ricardo De Leon, retired Brigadier General Roman Popong Felix, and all the good senators and congressmen and women. I am fortunate to have worked with past PNP chiefs because of the values I learned from them on leadership and character. My hats are off to ex-PNP chief Timmy Imperial, where I serve as an AD-CAM, and I am happy, and I know he's happy watching us now in heaven. Former PNP chief and now former Senator Panfilo Morena Lacson Sr., PNP chief Jesus Ami Versosa, and PNP chief Nicanor Ancheta Bartolome, and the many other great PNP chiefs that came before me. Thank you also to Attorney Benjamin Benhar Avalos Jr., sir, our Secretary of the Department of the Interior and Local Government, for his guidance for me to achieve the set goals, not only by him, but by no less than our Commander-in-Chief. I am also thankful to former Defense Secretary Gilbert Chudoro, Baguio City Mayor Benjamin Magalong, Office of the Presidential Advisor on Military Affairs, Undersecretary Isagani Neres, and retired Court of Appeals Associate Justice Mel for their contribution in resolving the issues that affect the Philippine National Police. Police Major General Eliseo Cruz deserves more than a pat on the back for leading the SITG 990. Thank you very much to Police Major General Benji Acorda, now our Chief PNP, for providing the intelligence. Thank you so much to Police Lieutenant General Benjamin Santos for your all-out support in all operations under your watch. Thank you to the members of the command group. Thank you very much to Police Major General Arthur Bisnar for guiding the D-Staff well during your incumbency as TCDS. Thank you also to my Office of the Chief PNP family, to all PNP officers, PNCOs, NUP, PNP Press Corps, and other media friends. Maraming salamat for joining me in my journey for the last 8 months as your Chief Philippine National Police. We were able to accomplish our goals through our collective efforts. My working principle has always been to challenge the status quo. This paved way for the Kasimbayanan program, which focuses on malasakit, kaayusan, kapayapaan, tungo sa kaunlaran. The aggressive fight against criminals led up to an improved peace and order and stability in the country. Our law enforcers focus on going after high-value targets, especially in the anti-drug campaign. There were also no reports of destabilization in the president's first 8 months in office, a feat in itself. Today, as I retire and stand before you, Mr. President, I can honestly say that I have achieved the goals I set for you and the Filipino people. As of today, your administration is stable. Under my leadership, since I assume as Chief PNP, the total crime volume decreased by 9,038, and I believe that this decline directly or indirectly contributed to the economic growth of the country. The latest data from Trading Economics shows that the inflation rate in the Philippines decreased from 8.6% in February 2023 to 7.6% in March 2023. Our Kasimbayanan program successfully organized and mobilized the community with religious leaders across affiliations supporting our Malasakit plus Kaayusan plus Kapayapaan equals Kaunlaran initiative to bridge the gap between the police and the community. We all share in the goal of the President, achieving Kaunlaran or development and economic recovery, especially amid the pandemic. I unmask the syndicates in the PNP that damaged its reputation using my strategy, and I quote, "Tapakan mo yung buntot, makikita mo yung ulo," unquote. Under your administration, Mr. President, we assure you that in our war on drugs, we will not name names or accuse anyone without sufficient evidence and cases filed against those who are involved. We promptly responded to allegations of high-ranking officers' involvement in drugs by filing our courtesy resignations along with other colonels and generals following the call of SILG Attorney Benjamin Abalos Jr.'s appeal through my own initiative and recommendation. As part of a five-man advisory group, we worked together with impartiality to conclude the proceedings efficiently. My dedication to serving this great nation does not end here. I take my commitment as a lifelong mission that will continue to motivate me to make a difference in this world, because I always believe that life is beautiful. I also leave you a quote from a poem from Mother Teresa entitled, "Do It Anyway." The good you do today may be forgotten tomorrow. Do good anyway. Give the world the best you have, and it may never be enough. Give your best anyway. For you see, in the end, it is between you and my God. It was never between you and them anyway. Finally, I would like to give thanks to our Heavenly Creator for His constant guidance, wisdom, and strength. Without Him, I would not be where I am today. Muli, isang mapagpalang araw sa ating lahat. Mabuhay ang nagkakaisang kapulisan, simbahan at pamayanan. Mabuhay ang pambansang pulisya. Mabuhay po tayong lahat. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much, sir.